The evidence was everywhere, and now we have answers. Valve have launched Steam Play and the beta Steam client. So what does this mean? How does it work? And what should we make of this massive news? Hi, I'm Gardiner, the Linux gamer, and let's talk about this. According to a write-up in the Steam for Linux community, Valve officially announced this new version of Steam Play and talked about the technology that enables playing Windows-exclusive games on Linux. So, Valve have essentially forked Wine, the open-source Windows compatibility layer that's been available to Linux users for ages, and created their own project called Proton. The name lends itself to comparison with Electron, but that's for a different video. Proton features a few improvements, specially tailored to the needs of integrating the project into Steam and focused on improving gaming performance throughout the translation layer. So, Windows games with no Linux version currently available can now be installed and run directly from the Linux Steam client, complete with native Steamworks and OpenVR support. DirectX 11 and 12 implementations are now based on Vulkan, resulting in improved game compatibility and reduced performance impact. Fullscreen support has been improved. Fullscreen games will be seamlessly stretched to the desired display without interfering with the native monitor resolution or requiring the use of a virtual desktop. Improved game controller support. Games will automatically recognize all controllers supported by Steam. Expect more out-of-the-box controller compatibility than even the original version of the game. Performance for multi-threaded games has been greatly improved compared to vanilla Wine. So Proton is an open source project under the MIT license, and it's available for use outside of Steam, which is rad. They are also contributing code that they deem useful back to Wine. Currently, Valve are officially supporting the development of DXVK and VKD3D, which are DirectX Vulkan translation layers for versions 11 and 12 of DirectX respectively. And they're rolling out Proton as part of the Steam beta client right now. Not all Windows games are supported, but a handful of games have been whitelisted as compatible with the new Steam Play initiative, including many titles that utilize Vulkan. The post goes on to say that a team at Valve are working on testing games and adding them to the supported list. This supported list will roll out without even requiring an update of the Steam client. Now, I've seen some people asking me why I'm excited about this news when I've, in the past, been opposed to playing Windows games on Linux through Wine. And it's a fair criticism. I think what's important here is that Valve are accounting for some of the issues that I've had with Windows games in Wine. First, while we don't have a solid grasp of how or if developers will receive metrics on Proton or Steam Play usage, I would imagine that they will be able to see these numbers. And that's hugely important from my perspective. I had to change my shirt, I got too sweaty. Second, as compatibility grows and Proton leaves beta, there is potential that this project will enable many people to ditch Windows completely in favor of Linux. I mean, seriously, I can't count the number of times I've heard friends and family and people online say, "I wish I could switch to Linux, but I have software on Windows that I can't live without." It's what the experts call vendor lock-in. And truthfully, it's games that most people are talking about. I believe that this could be what we need to achieve critical mass in Linux desktop adoption. Enabling people to have access to their Steam library on any platform is the right move, even if some titles simply won't work.
But Gardiner, we've had Wine forever. How is this any different?
All right, Steam will essentially work as a front end to this technology and enable it to work seamlessly for end users who aren't Linux savvy or who aren't interested in dicking around with Wine prefixes. That's huge. That's important. That's game changing.
Pun intended.
Besides, a company like Valve has the resources and the manpower to push the development of Wine forward. I suspect that this news will slowly start to turn the tide and Linux adoption will pick up the pace. But I mean, what can I say? I'm disgustingly optimistic. It's not all roses though. My biggest issue with playing Windows games has always been supporting devs who don't support Linux just isn't an idea I like. That issue still isn't solved here. It may, in fact, be magnified by Steam Play, at least in the short term. I'm still struggling with this. It's a big problem. It's doubly worrying when titles are brand new and the potential for a Linux port isn't completely ruled out. See, I'm not too concerned about playing games like BioShock or Max Payne. There's virtually no chance that they'll receive a native Linux port. But like Doom Eternal, for example, the greatest chance of the game being ported to Linux is arguably around the time of its launch. Despite Bethesda's seeming lack of interest in publishing anything for Linux. Got him. So the question needs to be asked. If a developer designs their game with Proton in mind, and ensures that it works well out of the box through Steam Play on day one, what does that mean for us? Should we interpret that as a gesture of goodwill and reward them with our hard-earned cash? Or should we turn our nose up at table scraps? More importantly, does this mean we'll end up with fewer native games? Ultimately, I feel like this is a Machiavellian decision by Valve. The last few years have proven that you really can't convince gamers to ditch Windows if it means they can't play 3/4 of the games they have in their Steam library. By adding Proton to Steam, it will hopefully convince more people to ditch the proprietary and ever more locked down walled garden that is Windows, and thereby convincing developers that Linux truly is the future of gaming. But what do you think? Are you as optimistic as I am, or are you still a skeptic? Or are you just excited to have more games available on Linux? Leave me a comment and let me know, or hit me up on Twitter at @TheLinuxGamer. If you believe in the work that I do, you can support the channel with a monthly contribution over on Patreon, or you can pick up a t-shirt. There's a link in the description. But no matter what you do, whether it's sharing this video with your friends or hitting that like button, don't forget to subscribe to see more from me, The Linux Gamer. And as always, thank you so much for watching.